people of this country who are victims of the policies of Narendra Modi government, either the victims of demonetization or GST or this mob lynching or whatever, or not allocating proper budgetary allocation for the NREGA. So these people have come together. Now they all sat in their own areas and they prepared their own demands, and today we all have come together and we have invited the political top leadership of the political parties, because we want to survive. We don't want any hatred, but we want our life and livelihood back. So that is why we are giving our charter of demands to the political parties to be included in their manifestos, and to, if they come to power, they must implement all those the promises which are there in the manifesto.
We want it to be a great nation, and a great nation is to think great. It has to have the concept of plurality of greatness that India has always had, and that has been systematically destroyed in the last 4 years, and it follows logically that they might even change the constitution. So this time we are voting on three very important aspects. We are voting for the constitution, we are also voting for democracy, because what has been done in the last 4 years is not democracy. We have destroyed institutional independence, we have co-opted the media. If you look at it in every way, which way, it is not democracy. So we are voting for democracy, we are voting for the constitution, and we are voting for complete accountability to deliver for the very poor people in this country.
हमारे साथ 2011 में ऐसी अटैक हुआ, हमारे जैसे कितना महिला बच्चे बूढ़े सब झेल रहे हैं हमारे जैसे, तो मैं भारत सरकार से कहना चाहूँगी कि ऐसी अटैक को लिए कुछ अच्छा कदम उठाए कि हम बेचारी बन के न जिए, किसी के ऊपर बोझ बन के ना रहे।
अपनी जो सरकार है ना, तो सरकार में कहा गया था कि जैसे विधवा एकल महिला है तो उनको सभी को पीएम आवास मिलेंगी, लेकिन देखो ये जो तस्वीरें हैं ना, उन्हीं महिला की हो जिन्होंने पीएम मोदी जी ने ये कहा था कि हम इनको सभी को मकान देंगे। दूसरी चीज़, इन महिलाओं की वो दशा हो गई जैसे कि वो चाहती थी कि हमें पेंशन बढ़ के मिलेगी, लेकिन जो मिलने वाली पेंशन थी वो भी 3-3 साल से बंद हो रही है।
लेडीज़ों को दिन पे दिन टॉर्चर करा जाता है, उन्हें शारीरिक रूप से, मानसिक रूप से, आर्थिक रूप से परेशान करा जाता है। अगर वो कोई कार्रवाई भी करना चाहे या किसी के साथ घरेलू हिंसा हो भी रही है, तो उसे बोला जाता है कि आप क्यों कार्रवाई कर रहे हो या आप क्यों कर रहे हो, तो इसके अगेंस्ट आप कोई कार्रवाई मत करें।
उज्ज्वला स्कीम, एंड एवरीवेयर यू कैन सी द फोटोग्राफ ऑफ मिस्टर नरेंद्र मोदी एंड विलेज वीमेन सेइंग दैट through Ujjala scheme we have empowered. And actually what is happening, the first cylinder and connection you will give free, but that free means minimum 500 or 1000 rupees we will have to go, that's a different thing. But what about the second, once that first cylinder is finished, how they will buy the second cylinder? So, and this is one part. On the one hand, you have given the connection, gas connection and cylinder. But on the other hand, every week you are increasing the price of cooking gas. And you are actually giving all sort of troubles to the women. And you are claiming that you have empowered. And not only that, now all those who have got the connection, Ujjala connections, many places they are being denied ration and pension, because now they are put in the list of APL.
It is science and technology and rationality and scientific temper on which Indian identity was built. For the last 5 years, not only institutions have been attacked, but even rationality has been attacked. And thus, we see a situation that those who are never going to fight elections, such as scientists, poets, writers, filmmakers, actors, and even civil society, have come out on the streets and are saying that is not acceptable anymore. Now, it becomes responsibility of every citizen of the country to say that attack on our Lok Shahi, attack on our constitution, an attack on our democracy and values of living together is not acceptable.
There are two or three important things. One is that when a government promises something, it has to absolutely deliver. If a government promises and does not deliver, we charge it the government. That's a very simple concept. So we are taking issue after issue, and there are 20 issues on which they have promised and they have not delivered. So there is a charge sheet. But there are also larger issues. They have gone against constitutional guarantees. They have attacked freedom of expression. They have attacked the notion of equality. Do you know that we are the second most unequal nation in the world after Russia? Do you know that we have the largest unemployment rate in 20 years? Now, these are figures which are stunning. And do you also know that 10% of India's population owns 73% of the wealth of India? Now, what kind of country are we living in?
There are two parts to it. One is a universal declaration, I would call it, that hate politics and violence becoming a way of leading a socio-political life has to end. That is where we are today, and there can be no denying that. If you just look around the country, the statistics will tell you, more than statistics, people's lives will tell you that we are, I think, in a very, very precarious stage in this country, and we have to recognize it. On the agenda, I think the voice of the people, irrespective of which sector you're talking about, lives of the people, their voices need to be part of what political parties believe their agenda is. So we are also trying to put to them what they need to hear. They need to hear what people want. I'm talking about every kind of people. This is about the environment, this is about the economy, this is about the culture, this is about society. So this whole discourse has to change. The discourse today is a discourse of chest beating, I would call ugly nationalism. And if you listen to the speeches by the Prime Minister or anybody else, that's all they're talking about today.
अगले 5 साल का एजेंडा होगा हमारा संविधान में जो अच्छे चीज हम जोड़ा था जो पिछले 5 साल में उसको निकालने का साजिश हुआ उसको वापस लाना हमारा देश में जो बड़े-बड़े प्रतिष्ठान हम तैयार किया था पिछले 70 साल में सारे प्रतिष्ठान को वो तोड़-फोड़ कर रहा है उसको दोबारा अपना मर्यादा में वापस लाना हमारा देश में शिक्षा व्यवस्था में सांप्रदायिकता घुसाने का काम हो रहा है उससे सेकुलर बनाने का कोशिश करना हमारा शिक्षा शास्त्र को प्राइवेट के हाथ में बेचने का जो साजिश चल रहा है उसको हाथ से लेके हमारा देश का जनता का हित में शिक्षा शास्त्र व्यवस्था को कायम करना
आई एम रियली वरीड फॉर आवर कॉन्स्टिट्यूशन आई एम रियली वरीड फॉर आवर सेक्युलर बीइंग आई एम रियली वरीड आई थिंक वी आर ऑल वरीड दैट वेयर विल दिस लीड एंड यू नो व्हाट बदर्स मी इज द एंगर And I can't sometimes even fathom the anger. I can't talk to you anymore. I can't just say, I disagree with you. Let's talk. That seems impossible. Families are not able to talk to their uncles and aunties and cousins. This has not happened before in this country.
Whether this way or that way, the struggle will continue.